them kids at that conference.
I'm not sitting on my own.
After 6 o'clock, I'd like to call to order the July meeting of the Winfield City Council. If everyone would please rise for the invitation. And then join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. Have Brother Frank Fuller here tonight and lead us in our invocation.
Please pray with me. Gracious Heavenly Father, we ask your blessing this day on the city of Winfield, on those who lead it, those who protect it, and all those who dwell therein. Please invest all of us gathered here together this evening with the spirit of wisdom, justice, and mercy, that they may make wise decisions for all who dwell here. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of our country.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, the first item on the agenda is guest and audience participation. Do we have anybody in the audience who would like to address the council tonight? Okay, come, if you'll come up or stand up at least, ma'am, and come up here. Give us your name.
Kathleen King.
Kathleen King.
Uh-huh. I live on Payne Street, and I have a little problem already with the dogs. We have big dogs in my neighborhood. They're loose runners. I was actually chased by one on the way here, getting towing out to my car, and there was one on the corner that was loose. And then I have two neighbors in the back that both have big dogs that don't chain them or keep them chained up at all. So the new events with the dog pound not being open have caused a real problem for me already. So it's really a problem for me. And that's all I have tonight. I got more, but that's enough for one day.
And what's your address?
My address is 100. Payne.
That's North Payne? Or?
It's North Payne.
So I have a question. Have we just let dogs loose from the pound around the street?
No, we have not.
Okay. Yeah. No, I didn't think that was a problem, but I live so close to the highway that when people are going to let their dogs out, which they do, I don't understand it, but they do, and somehow they tend to make it, I guess, in our neighborhood, but I've seen more the last... Well, I saw two loose ones today that were... strays, and then I had black and white pit bull meet me at my car night before last. And when you meet a pit bull at your car at night, I'm terrified of them. So it's a problem for me.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Anyone else? Okay.
My name is Amelia Lutz. I live in town. I'm actually with the Humane Society. I work with cats usually, but I do tend to be a bleeding heart, so just whatever animal. But all of the shelter animals have been saved from the Humane Society, or from the shelter. Some of them were transported to our partners in Michigan, and they'll find good homes up there because they don't have the problems that we do down here. Namely, not having a spay and neuter law like they do. What I wanted to say was this motion to lease the animal shelter to the Humane Society. I wanted to address that because with what she just spoke on, if we were allowed the option to lease, this would give us more room to place more animals to keep them off the street. We wouldn't be animal control necessarily, but when people dump their animals, we would have more places for them to go instead of just foster homes like we do now.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
With that being said, I guess I'll say, kind of open the door. Shawn Moss, and I live right here in Winfield on Lennox Street. Not with the Humane Society any longer, but I'm still foster some, and yeah, they know where I am, and they know where to find me. I've been looking into some state laws, and as far as like shelters and who's responsible for shelters and how it can be done with the Humane Society. So as y'all think about leasing that to the Humane Society, Parrish is supposed to help out with animal control. And so, I mean, that's something that we need to talk to the police jury about. And it's been there and it's done that, but maybe not. Maybe it could be done better. But there are some laws, and I do have copies of them if y'all want to look at it after.
Okay. Thank you.
Excuse me, Mark.
Yes.
Are you saying, so you're thinking instead of a lease, maybe a partner, to partner with them?
Oh, no, I'm not going to go there. I hadn't thought that far in advance. We tried that one time. Didn't work out very well.
I think that would be something to look into.
I would think that you would need some kind of an animal control officer. And I did read, and I haven't read every statute by any means, because there's a million of them pertaining to animals. But there is one that said something about, you know, working with the Humane Society and giving them some authority to do some things. But don't by any means try to think that I know anything about those laws. I just printed them out. That's something I would like for you to look at.
Thank you.
My question is going to be our city attorney. Are we legally, can we actually lease out this in the city?
Can you what then?
Can we lease the animal shelter?
I don't see why not. This is, you can, as long as you get whatever you get out of it. You know, it's kind of, you can't give it away. Give public property away, but yeah, you can lease it.
We lease the Political Hall of Fame Museum to the, that we lease also. That's a property we own.
So who's going to be responsible for?
That's, we're going to bring that up later. That's
part of the contract, whoever will be responsible for.
I'd like for y'all that may not know that years ago, and I don't know what year it was, I think Mr. Goff was the mayor at the time, that I don't remember what the funds were, but the Humane Society, a grant from the Humane Society from the state, actually added on to that shelter, made it twice as large as it was. It was just that one little building. Now there's a lot more runs, and they redid what was the building that was supposed to be where the cats were housed. And anyway, a lot of improvements were done with grant and just from the Humane Society.
And a partnership would be the most viable option, in my opinion, because if we do lease the building, some one of us volunteers are going to have to take care of the shelter itself. So that just adds more, you know, it's just another liability for us, not for y'all, but it would be a liability for us just having somebody up there. So if there is an option to partner with the state, like she brought up, I think that would be in our best interest in the cities, really.
And when we get to that on the agenda, that'll be something that'll be part of when we get talked about, you know, what the contract will say and how we want to draw it up. That'll all, and we'll meet with the police jury, and we'll meet with other interested parties, and then we'll decide exactly how that agreement will be written up. So, premature just yet.
Okay. Anyone else from the audience wants to address the council? Okay. If not, we'll move to number four, which we do need to amend the agenda. It would be new business action item number 14. Give me the mayor the authority to sign this approval of agreement for transfer of entitlements for the airport. We were eligible for a grant for the airport back in 2014, and because we don't have 10 airplanes housed out there anymore, we don't qualify for the grant or the funds anymore. Isn't that correct?
Correct. So what this would do is it
transfers, the $117,000 that we could have gotten, it will stay in the state of Louisiana. If we don't execute the agreement, it can be distributed throughout the United States.
This way.
But at least the $117,000 would go.
So that's, you want to put that on the agenda?
I want to put that on the agenda as new business action item number 14.
So moved, any other?
Have a motion by Junkin to add, have a second by Miller. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Now need a motion to approve the agenda as amended.
So moved.
Have a motion by Demery, second by Miller. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Now, I kind of jumped ahead there when I did the guest and audience ahead of that. Now we go to old business action items. Number one is the adoption of Ordinance 15 of 2017, the sale of the fire rescue unit to the Wynn Parish Fire District. Mr. Miller.
An ordinance to declare a surplus and provide for the sale of the 2008 Dodge Fire Rescue Unit, serial number 3D6WH48AX8G223509, to provide for related matters and to provide an effective date therefore. Please consider this introduced.
This is an
Pardon me. So I put this in the form of a motion.
Second.
And I would just like to make a comment. I believe that it's already been arranged that the parish is prepared to make this purchase at the appraised value of $40,000.
I have a motion and a second. Motion by Miller, second by Junkin. Any questions before we vote? Not. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Okay. Number two, adoption of Ordinance 17 of 2017, amending Section 19-6. One. Miller.
An ordinance to amend Section 19-6.1 of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Winfield, Louisiana, to provide for an increase in the charge for implementing and maintaining a water clarification system, to provide for related matters, and to provide an effective date therefore. And I put that in the form of a motion.
Second.
And just some information pertaining to this. Currently, we are charging the average resident customer 22 cents per 1,000 gallon. This would propose a 38-cent increase. Average household uses 4,000 gallons, which would equate to about $1.52 a month increase. $1.52 a month increase. Which would bring in an estimated $100,000 to go towards maintaining our water system. And the primary reason for that would be to alleviate some of the strain on our reserve funds, depleting our reserve funds.
Okay, did I have a second? I have a second by Junkin. All in favor, say aye.
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 That's three. All opposed? Any abstentions? One abstention. Mr. Edwards?
Second. No.
Are you abstaining?
Both no.
No. Three A's, one no, and one abstention. Motion carries. Okay. Old business, non-action, we have none. New business, action. Number one is to accept the minutes from the June 13th regular meeting.
So moved.
Winfield City Council. Have a motion by Miller.
Second.
Second by Demery. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Number two, accept the minutes from the June 29th, 2017 special meeting of Winfield City Council.
Second.
A motion by Demery, second by Junkin. All in favor, say aye.
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 Number three is an...
I abstain, but I wouldn't have that meeting.
Okay, you abstain. Okay. One abstention.
Everybody else in favor?
Were you, did you vote yay, Mr.?
I wasn't.
So you abstaining too?
Yes.
Have two abstentions. Number three, introduction of ordinance 20 of 2017, summer recreation program. Councilwoman Demery.
I talked to, this afternoon about this. It really, he said it couldn't be put into an ordinance, but I just wanted to say, when we start looking at the budget for 18-19, which we will have to do because it'll have to go into effect by July 1st, just want to make sure that we keep that recreation program for the college kids to work, that we include that in that budget. That's what I want.
That's the amount, what was the amount, $15,000?
It was about $11,500, I believe, for labor and then supplies.
He's whatever he always had to put in, I mean, you know, it could be whatever. It just had to be included, it would be included in the budget here for next year.
And that's the program that they can also kind of do.
Oh, this will be the new budget.
The new budget for next year. It's in.
They did it for this one.
It's a program that can get to go on, it's raising my one.
All right.
So it's not an ordinance.
No, it's not, it's just a...
A very strong reminder.
For this year, was that program continued or was that part?
We had a meeting in this one.
Yeah, we talked about it for the funding.
Yeah, it was kind of a bit...
We talked about the same thing, right?
We put a trailer from the...
For next year. Number four is a condemnation of Eloise Brown Estate, 610 West Avenue.
Trying to get that thing done, Mr. Ma'am. Okay, here we go. It was service on, by Mr. Walton, on folks in Grant Parish on June 30th, which is more than 10 days ago. So nothing condemned or whatever you want to do with it. They're all familiar with the property, I know where it's at. I don't have any pictures of it.
610 West Ave.
I'm gonna file this with the clerk.
Okay. We'll make a motion to condemn that, right, we'll make a motion to condemn that property.
Okay, have a motion.
Sidney told me, anyway, when he talked to the lady, Grant Parish, she was supposed to be trying to ask somebody to put the chair down, but I don't know where it happened.
Okay, have a motion by Mr. Hams to condemn the Eloise Brown Estate, 610 West Avenue. Have a second by Demery. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Kind of timeframe.
Motion carries.
30 days.
30 days.
Okay.
Okay.
Next folder.
The next, yeah, number five, six, seven, and eight are all housekeeping things to be done in conjunction with an LCDVG application at the city. For the funding year of 18-19, you have to do it 2 years in advance, and for a sewer rehabilitation project, which has a great chance to get funded, because sewer has high priority. So the number five is a motion to adopt a citizen participation plan and complaint procedure and appoint Susan Kelly as the citizen complaint officer for compliance with the LCDVG program.
So moved.
A motion by Miller.
Second.
Second by Mr. Edwards. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Number six is a motion to authorize Kai Bevel, the chief elected official, to proceed with the development of the LCDBG application, taking into consideration views and proposals submitted by citizens that attended the public hearing, as well as those who were unable to attend, and the views of the governing body. Motion?
So moved.
Motion by Miller.
Second.
Second by Junkin. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. A motion to adopt procurement policy for compliance with the LCDBG program.
So moved.
Motion by Miller.
Second.
Second by Demery. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Motion to authorize Kai Bevel, the chief elected official, to proceed with the procurement and selection of professional services for the purpose of assisting in the development of the LCDBG application and implementation of the project.
So moved.
Motion by Miller, second by Demery. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Number nine is the motion to lease the animal shelter to the Humane Society.
And that is the motion I'm putting before the council for their agreement to try to work together with Humane Society, that we can help provide them with actual location, a physical property. The actual lease would have to be, you know, agreed to between the Humane Society and the council and the mayor and the attorneys involved. But it would be something that would be assisting them to get into play as far as being able to house animals that are loose on the streets, working with the parish. I've talked to a couple of police jurors, and they are willing to talk. They have invited, if some of the Humane Society people would like to come to their meeting and talk to them, and maybe put forward that we all need to work together to try to get this thing done. But the first step would be for us as council members to agree that we would be open to leasing the building to the Humane Society as a starting place.
My question is that we had some problem with Humane Society in the mayor. How did y'all resolve those problems?
Pretty much what, but this would, you know, I've talked to them, and I'm for trying to work something out with them, and they would actually run the shelter. We were trying to run the shelter in conjunction with them before. We ran into some conflicts.
So now they would run the shelter.
But they would actually run the shelter and take care of it and use it to house and hopefully save most of the animals that were turned in there.
So what part would we play for us? Any of our employees would be able to work along with them in the event that they're not able to be down here?
No, it's going to be their responsibility. That would be only on a volunteer basis by our employees.
Our employees are only on a volunteer basis?
Yeah, they would just volunteer like any other member or anybody else in the community that wanted to volunteer to help the Humane Society. We will not be providing employees. We're just kind of like the landlord.
Okay, but we lost an employee from that shelter a few weeks ago, right?
Right.
That's correct.
Right. And I know that I've talked to a few people who have said that she's possibly thought about maybe becoming an employee of either the parish or the police jury or the Humane Society itself to maybe help continue with that, but that won't have anything to do with the city.
Seems like there'll be more discussion with this.
You guys feel comfortable with it?
Just a motion.
We do feel comfortable if we have to. I feel like the partnership, if the city, or not the city, the parish took some responsibility, and maybe we could get a worker. If Camelia, who was the worker for the city, did work for the parish, if she wanted to come back, she would be with us.
Can't put words in the mouth just yet.
Yeah, I know.
It's just something we dropped because of the funding cuts.
Yes.
Didn't have anything to do with the relationship.
She is still part of the Humane Society.
But this proposal is to be able to afford the Humane Society with an affordable option as far as a location and to house animals and, you know, keep a facility that you would be responsible for. And as in the past, the Humane Society has been responsible for the facility in many ways anyway. So it's not going to be a drastic transition for them to come in and take care of the animals and the facility, because they've been doing that on and off for years. sometimes almost on a full-time basis.
I would agree to it. We'd have to talk to it, but that was something, that would be something that I would.
Like I said, we're gonna meet with police jury too, to see what kind of involvement they were willing to.
This is not, it's not a done deal, as far as I'm concerned. This would be something that would have to be drawn up and be a work in progress that hopefully we could all agree on as them and the council and all, and to make it work. This is not, this motion is not to, in my way I see it, it's not.
Signing the lease.
Signing the lease.
No, this motion is for us to agree that it's a good idea to try to do this.
Getting the lease up and seeing how we can make it work with them and the parish and us, hopefully.
You had a list of questions or whatever. I'm sure they'd be more than happy to get their answers for you.
Yeah.
What terms would be that, the motion would be to enter a negotiation for the city and the Humane Society for the lease of the building?
Not to lease us specifically, but to negotiate. That's what I'm asking.
We also have the parish in it. You're gonna bring them in, would they also be on this?
That would be between the Humane Society and the parish. That has, that would be their, that would be the contribution of the parish would be to the Humane Society, not to us. So that's a separate deal.
So we need to change the wording.
Yeah, so the motion would be. What I'm trying to say is I would like to enter into negotiations to lease the property.
So the motion, if the motion would be motion to enter lease negotiations.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
That's how I like the word. And I put that in the form of a motion.
Second. They have a motion to enter into lease negotiations of the animal shelter with the Humane Society by Junkin and a second by Miller. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? That motion carries. Number 10 is a motion to add Shannon Chevalier as a member of the Recreation Board. We had done revision to the ordinance. I believe Mr. Edwards had introduced it a month or so ago to, about adding a person from the parish to the Recreation Board. Mary Ann Little, who was serving on the board, that's a five-member board, has resigned because of conflicts of time. And so that left, that opened that slot. And so Shannon, this motion is to add her to replace Mary Ann Little on the Recreation Board.
Second.
You made a motion.
I'll make the motion.
Miller makes a motion. Who's got the second?
I know he introduced it, but yeah, whatever.
It wasn't this specific. Okay, Miller made the motion to add Shannon Chevalier as a member of the Recreation Board. Edwards, second. Okay. All in favor, say aye. Motion carries. Any opposed?
Do you have that policy over there that was floating around?
Yeah, this?
Yeah, that's it.
Number 11 is motion to adopt the hiring and firing policy. Mr. Hams.
Well, it's just a motion to adopt a part of the policy coming up that we already have in place. It's basically for protection of our employees, some that have been laid off. It's like a seniority clause as well as a layoff and recall clause. That's a part of it, you know. And so I think most of the council members had already read it. And so I'm just going to make a motion to adopt that as part of our policy moving forward.
My question is, are there some things changed since the last time we got a copy of this? Has anything changed?
What were the changes?
Yeah, that stuff in there that's highlighted.
It's highlighted.
Does any of this, since we're, does any of this limit any of the hiring, firing controls of the mayor?
It had to do with seniority.
Right.
It was strictly for the employee.
Right, but I just want to make sure it doesn't restrict the mayor's.
It don't restrict anyone. It just keep people involved.
Because that would be illegal. Okay.
That's not illegal.
All right, now I just want to make sure that it doesn't restrict him.
Motion motion to adopt the hiring and firing policy by Mr. Hams. Second by Edwards.
One more question. At one point, Mr. Hams, you had stated that you would like to have in place here, and I'm just skimming this, I don't see it, but that all hires and fires would be brought before the council?
That is not in that particular.
That is not in there.
That's a termination policy.
And the highlighted portions are the changes from the last draft that we saw.
Yeah, the additions.
Yeah, they don't have, they have just changed today. I don't want to say they added that section to the day. I want to register it to. Go ahead.
My only concern when it comes to, when you're looking at total seniority, is if you have to do a layoff and you have an employee who has certifications or something else that would possibly supersede seniority in that case for a particular department, whether it be water, wastewater, or something else that.
It says something about if I job qualified, and this is somebody who's qualified, and if somebody's qualified, whatever, not hiring anybody, if the place I'm placed qualified, if the other ones, I guess, more qualified, and they would tell me. I think it says actually the job classification and seniority, so like the street department would be one classification, the water department would be another, and your seniority within the department.
My concern would be there, if you're going to stipulate layoffs based on seniority, which I understand that, but if you have a department where you have one employee that's been there longer than another one, maybe that has been there slightly less, but the employee that has been there longer has maybe not as stellar of a work record as opposed to the one that has been there slightly less time frame, how would that work?
It's a gray area in that, Mr. Mill. If you just read over some of the gray area in that where the mayor just read, she's showing not necessarily seniority. It goes with certifications as well and different things. We're never going to policy in place, so you got employees. It's like, how can you govern a municipality and the employees don't even know what's going on? It has nothing in place for them to, you know, be governed by. You know, and so it's putting something in place that they can actually read and say, I understand.
Right.
So, and with no policy at all, I mean, they just running around here lost.
Yes, sir.
I think you need a hire and fire policy.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Number two, I think you got to be careful when you do it, because if you put one in effect, then you're bound by it. It's your current employees. And if there's something wrong with it, you're going to get yourself in a trap without getting a review and look at that.
That's the reason I say everybody should read it and review it. Yeah. So we, and like I say, it's something that's been trying to be implemented for the last 3 years, and you have nothing to do with it. So that's.
This motion is to adopt one. It doesn't have to, we can agree to adopt one, and then
now this would be what would be adopted, correct?
I think the ordinance is written is that we could do a motion and possibly present it's adopted, right?
Do what?
The way that you both provided the ordinance was.
Yeah, I did. That's all we have to go through all the process.
Right.
But I had to hire it. So,
okay. okay, everybody comfortable with it?
Motion by Hamble, second by Edwards.
That's why we've been good to have this before. Okay, we have a motion by Mr. Hams and a second by Mr. Edwards to adopt hiring and firing policy. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Okay, number 12. A motion to explore the possible lease or sale of electric system through an RFP issuance. What that is just to what it says, to be able to explore or request a proposal from an interested party to see what kind of options we have out there concerning our electric system. We are in a situation right now, personnel-wise, that is very, very short-handed, very slim. Experience-wise, our electric utility supervisor is turned in his resignation, and his last day is next Friday. And so I've been trying to call, put out ads, whatever we can do to replace that person, and have not had success yet. We have, as I said at another meeting, we have three options that we need to look at. I feel like one is to hire people and get them in here to run our system, which would be the best option, but that hasn't happened yet. The second option would be to hire a contractor to come in and help or run our electric system. And that, when I say running, I'm talking about the maintenance and the that goes with it, replacing transformers, replacing line, storm damage, also substation, everything, meters, all of that goes with it. Whether it be on a temporary basis or a semi-permanent type basis. The third would be to explore the lease or sale of the system through an RFP, which is just a request. Before anybody that is interested would even put in the due diligence and the effort to look at this, they have to know that it's not, the council's not totally opposed, because it will take some time and effort on interested parties to come in and do a study and see what kind of, what they can offer us and so forth. And that's what this motion is for, just so we can put out feelers and see if the interested parties can then come and possibly make an offer, and we can look at that as an option.
It's going to be a good offer.
Right.
You ask a question, Mayor. What portion of this electrical is coming in as our income for the city?
The city, the electric system, over the history of Winfield, we live basically off our electric system. So it would have to be a very good proposal that we could live with.
So why would we sell the only real income that we got coming?
Well, the only reason, my concern is, one, that this system that we have here and with our new substation and everything else, is it's no good to us if we don't have people to run it. And electric reliability for our citizens, our businesses, our medical facilities, our schools is paramount. It's a 24-hour a day, 7-day a week reliability issue. And it's, if you don't have the people in place and get them here that can do it, then, you know, we could be be.
In the dark.
In the dark, literally. And we don't want that to happen. And it's a very, very concern, big concern of mine right now, and has been for several months. And it's qualified linemen are in very short supply. They're not out there that you can just pluck them here and there and get somebody in here. Winfield has lived for a long time on local people that lived here and had ties here. And we, right now, the doesn't seem to be any qualified people locally. And typically an apprentice works 5 to 7 years as an apprentice before they're actually moved up and considered a lineman. And I'm working diligently to try to see if we can get someone hired. I'm trying to get a proposal or two on getting some contract help in here on a temporary basis to make sure we can fill that void or that gap. And then this would be another option. And it may not go anywhere. We may look at it and say it's not going to work, but I think we ought to be willing to at least consider it.
Let me ask you another question. Let's say we do look at this and we decide to do a proposal. Say it's $12 million, $15 million. Once that $15 million gone, where are we going from there with income?
Well, that's a good question. The deal would have to work with some kind of perpetual income that came off of it. That's the only way that it could work. And that what that could be, don't know yet until we get some proposals.
Now, there is a proposal that comes in and they do want to purchase from us, what would they do to our rates? Well, as business people, they would go up to like energy or something.
Anytime somebody comes in, they purchase it, it's going
to
go up.
I think we all know at some point our rates are going to have to go up one way or another.
I guess my thing is, if we raise the rates, and I know everybody's against it, but if we do it, we can do a small enough amount that we can, you know, finally work it on up eventually, gradually. But if we give it to somebody else, they can come in here and just
they would be
slap
good.
Whatever rates they want because they have to make profit.
But this would be about employees. I mean,
that too.
And this would be about rates at this point.
It would be about all of it. It would be about everything.
We
wouldn't own it.
I know. They would have, we wouldn't be.
They would be governed by the Public Service Commission.
They would? Okay. That's what I was, I guess that's what
I'm saying. They can't raise rates without being approved through the Public Service Commission. We don't have to have that approval as a municipality.
Right.
But they would.
Would we have any say in it?
Nope.
In the rates?
Yeah.
We could call our Public Service Commission representative. Complain about that, I would just
comment, you know, that I think that we do need to consider all of the options. You know, I think that we need to consider trying to get our pay scale up, primarily trying to get our pay scale up in order to be able to attract a lineman with a competitive salary. I think that's the number one problem. How do we do that? Well, you know. There are other options, but and then also, I'm okay with proceeding just to see what offers are out there, but I'm not in favor of selling our utility system just right up front.
This is
a glance at it, but I do realize we do need to be able to consider all the options. But we've got problems there because we depend on the revenue and. But primarily, I think that we need to be able to get our pay scale up in order to attract a lineman to locate here and work here. We also need to consider the options of, subcontracting out until we can find someone. I mean, that we got to be able to service our utility system. People expect their lights to be able to pay for it.
Yep.
Light source is not going to help us either because you're going to take another percentage of the income that are coming in, and basically we'll about the flat line now, so why we do go ahead?
So where we.
We have some serious thoughts here about what you're talking about.
Because if, you know, with the, if our electric dependability is the most important and our electric service is the most important thing we have, in our, as far as our departments go, as far as the city goes, because of our revenue, the electric department is number one. Because we can't pump water, we can't run our sewer plant, we can't do anything without power. And if that power is out for any length of time, that was one of the reasons that I was told that the new substation was built, was because of the danger of that old station. If something happened and they couldn't find a part for it because it was antiquated, that we could be in a blackout unless we pulled in some outside generation for possibly weeks at a time. And that was before I was mayor. But this is the same type of situation that we're looking at here. It's all about being, having a reliable, dependable source of power here for our citizens and our businesses and our schools and everything else. And every business owner, pretty much, I think you've talked to, it's hard to attract people to Winfield and Wynn Parish right now. It is. I've talked to many of them. It's not easy. If it's somebody that doesn't have roots here, family here, or something like that, there's nothing to hold them here. And that's another danger about hiring from the outside. But we've got to have qualified people in place.
Right.
And it's our customers, it's a responsibility of ours, and that's what I'm working on and been working on. And we'll have a meeting probably with before another week's over about something as far as I wish it would be to hire somebody. That would be the best solution. But otherwise, it's going to be to try to get somebody in here to help us temporarily in case we're in need. It's like the storm we had back on right on Memorial Day.
So I'm saying is that with all this $6 million bond that we have to struggle to pay, if they did come in, they probably would take over that, but that would cut in on the amount of income that we would get from that. So either way go here, it looks to me that we need to try and come up with a way to get some raises here and get some qualified people in. I don't think going out selling what we have, and the only really income that we really have above water and sewer and stuff like that, I think that's a really bad idea. There's got to be a better way than this, and we just have to come up with it.
Okay.
And we need to put that out to the citizens and let them come up with an idea and put it out there and see what they say. You know, and they have a big part in this. So. But I don't think selling the revenue that we have is carrying us right now is the best thing, the best interest in the city of Winfield.
Okay.
But I do believe that we need to come to some kind of decision on it.
I agree, but to answer that, we've got to get our pay scale up to attract someone qualified to come in here as a lineman.
Let's go back and just either vote on whether to explore this.
Just to get some numbers.
Or get some numbers and see who's interested to visit. And go from there. We're not obligating ourselves in any way. It just would be part of looking at all our options. So I wanted the city council to be aware of it and be willing to at least look at the numbers, because if somebody says we're interested, you've got to come in and do a study of your rates, do a study of your customers and the condition of your transmission system and so forth. It's going to take them some time and effort to do that. And if the door is closed on this issue, then we don't want somebody to go to that trouble.
We need to close the door.
Okay.
Then I'll take 5 and 1 and see if we can move some solutions. But selling what we got is not a solution.
Well, this is just to explore. So I take it yours is no, but you'll get a chance to vote on that here in just a second, so. Do I even have a motion? I guess if I don't have a motion, it'll die without a motion, but that'll settle it.
This is just exploring.
We're just exploring and trying to see.
Just to get some numbers and look at it. Okay, so you're making the motion, Ms. Demery?
Just to get some.
Okay.
Because we could eventually have a special call meeting if they would like to do all of it.
Sure, we'll have several of those, I'm sure, to talk about it. Okay, I have a motion by Demery. Do I have a second? Second by Junkin.
There's nothing wrong with a little more information.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed?
No.
Edwards, no. Mr. Hamilton, standing or?
As long as you're exploring and not come back in the morning and it's sold, you know.
I can't do that.
Okay.
So you're yay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Abstain.
Abstain. Okay. Okay, number 13 is the Sheffield and Sheffield contract.
This possibly could have been involved in litigation, so I suggest we go into executive session and talk about this thing real quick. We'll take this for a few minutes.
Okay. We're going to adjourn for just a minute. We have to have a motion.
Yeah, so motion to go into executive session.
Second.
Motion by Junkin, second by Demery. And all in favor, 6:53.
Sir, how are you doing?
I'm good.
Thank you for doing it.
No.